NerdDice.
Welcome to this stateless Codecast. This is episode number 58 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. And in this episode, we're going to take a look at this total ability scores method. So before we had implemented roll ability scores, which returns an array of dice sets, in our last episode, we implemented the harvest totals method, which will take a collection of objects that responds, where each of them responds to total, and return the value, the result of executing that total method. So what we want now is, if we go back to our issue here, is the situation where we can get nerddice.totalAbilityScores and just get the array of numbers. Sometimes you just want the numbers, and this is what we're implementing now. So this will use a combination of what we've got with roll ability scores and what we just did with harvest totals. So let's get into it, and we'll start writing our specs here. So this is going to be similar to, in its interface, to roll ability scores, and because of that, I'm just going to check that it passes the options. To the roll ability scores method. So we're not going to do a lot going through and validating colors on the dice or something like that, because they don't really matter. So we just want to make sure that the options get passed on. We don't really care much beyond that. So I'll go in and write our it statements, and then we'll go from there. So I've got my it statements written for this. Let's start taking a look. So one of the things we're going to do here is we're going to expect that roll ability scores gets called appropriately. So we'll make that one of our items, and then we'll make information about the expected values the other item. So before each of these, we're just going to specify our seed. As we have previously. Specify here our configuration. Got that, and then with these we also need a let block. Method options, we'll use what we've used before. And then what we want to do here is we will expect the describe class to receive roll ability scores with method options and we want it to call the original. And then we'll just call describe class dot total ability scores with method options. And then in our items here, we just want expect to equal and we want to temporarily do this. Getting and then our without options we'll do something similar. So let's see how far we've gotten there. If we can spec NerdDice class methods total ability score spec. So none of this has been implemented yet, so we should expect a no method error on all of this. One error occurred outside of the examples. Oh, yeah, no equal sign there. I think I have to do a do end block to get that to work properly. Again, we've got failures. Our method has not been defined, which we're okay with at this point. Let's define our method. So we'll create a new file. Total ability scores. Harvest totals as our example class here. I will get rid of the method, update the comments, alright, so I've got my comments in place. It's going to look very similar to roll ability scores. Now let's write our method. And it's going to be very similar to this. That's all we need. So we'll just delegate rollability scores, harvest totals, the two methods we've worked on our previous items, and combine them. In class methods, we need to require this. And hopefully, at least our spec about it calling the value will start passing. Yep, we're down to two failures. So we've got, let's just make sure that they are consistent. They do not appear to be yet. So 816. So our second one is, so we'll see what's happening in our first one here. Get rid of some of these. So we are maybe we're just not. Specific enough and before each. .2218 out of .21. Still not getting us consistently. Using randomized here. See if we've got consistency now. Yes, that seems to have fixed it. So you can probably get rid of this each specification, which is redundant. Place our expectations. Save. Try it again. We're passing. Let's get rid of our puts results now. Same thing here. Still passing. We've gotten rid of the broken something. Total ability scores. Changed this time. All right, let's take a look at what we're doing here. Randomization technique, random object seed. Randomization technique, random rand seed. Let's see if that affects anything. Something completely random now without options. I'm only calling it in the one method there, so maybe I just don't even bother putting it in a block. Short enough in our spec. Let's get back to that's working. This is just returning a different value each time. Why is that? Let me try switching the orders. What I don't understand is that it's working when I call it from here. It's not working when I call it from the entire suite. Let me see what I get back each time I run this. Seed is nil. Our seed is nil. I'm just gonna run it with spec here. What if I can do a dash dash fail fast? Here we go. Prior seed. Getting a value there. 7331, which shouldn't affect anything related to the new seed. Let me double check to make sure I'm calling it with the correct values here. Refresh seed. Random rand seed, random object seed. just try doing random rand and seeing if we get consistent results this way. It's going to fail both ways, but at least 13, 8, 15, 11, 18, 12. Still not consistent. Still getting different values each time here. So I'm going to try explicitly in a before block. See if we get consistent values when we do it that way. So that's giving me the same array. Let's see what happens with All right, so that's failing consistently with those values. So we can try using those values. Passing whole version, passing. All right, so I think we've got that solved. RuboCop's probably not going to like the instance variable set, but we'll see. One offense. Let's see if we can get that fixed. All right, let's take a look at the RuboCop documentation for this. So we've got it. So this is one, it looks like RuboCop can go either way. So let me see what my enforced style is in my RuboCop config. Let's be more specific. Looks like we don't have it specified in our rubocop.yaml at all. So we'll just specify it. So we've got forced style receive is what we want, and the value here is message spies. What happens when we unnecessary disabling in execute die roll method. So let's take a look at that. Shared examples, the execute die roll method. Let's see if we can just get rid of it. No offenses detected. Still passing. There we go. So I think we can take a look at our git status. We want all of that. Write my commit message. So I've got my commit message. I'll sign it. And I noticed that I left in this comment that isn't actually true. So I'll go in pushed yet, so there's no edit. And no edit. Still sign it. Should be good. Now want to push. Check our NerdDice CI. So our build passes. Our backlog item is done, and we are getting very close to our 0.3 release. So all we've got left from a coding standpoint is adding the ability score functionality to the benchmarks suite. And then we've got to make sure our comments are up to date, which I think we've been doing a good job with since our last epic. So I don't think we're going to need much there. And then the update of the changelog, again, the comments have been pretty good. So it's going to be mostly just harvesting information out of those comments that we have at the method level for most of that. So we'll knock those out soon. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.